Okay, solving homework for section 8.4. Question number one. You work for a marketing firm that has a large client in the automobile industry. You have been asked to estimate the proportion of households in Chicago that have two or more vehicles. You have been assigned to gather a random sample that could be used to estimate this proportion to within 0.04 margin of error, okay? Margin of error, 0.04, all right? Of error at 90% level of confidence, okay? Confidence level, 90%, okay. With no prior research, what sample size should you gather in order to obtain 0.04 margin of error? Round your answer up to the nearest whole number. So for this type of problem, we are going to use StatCrunch. Since we are dealing with proportion, I'm going to StatCrunch, clicking Stat. Here it is, right below T-Stat, Z-Stat. T-stat and proportion stat. And we are using proportion statistics with the sample size because we are going to deal with sample size, right? We need to find sample size. Confidence interval, here is given 0.95, we need 0.90. Target proportions, since not given, we leave it 50%. Width, that's our margin of error. So since we have 0.04, and that's for one tail, we need to double it, 0.08. Okay, and the sample size we are going to compute, and we are getting 423 sample size. Okay, let's go back. 423, since I am in teacher's preview, I can check the answer right away. There we go, 423, correct. Next one, your firm has decided that your plan is too expensive and they wish to reduce the sample size required. You conduct a small preliminary sample and you obtain a sample proportion, p hat 0.19. Okay, that's the proportion. And using the new information, what sample size should you gather to obtain 0.04? We already have that 0.04 margin of error. And we need to round, and it's still gonna use 90% of confidence interval. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do here. We are coming back to the same. I need to move this. Okay, I can't move it. So I'm closing and starting over. Okay, stat, proportion stat, and with sample size. Okay, now confidence interval is 90, 0.9. Target we had 0.19, right? Proportion 0.19. 0.19, okay. With that margin of error, we are going, because it was given 0.04 for one tail, so we need to double it for two tails, 0.08. Okay, and sample size is going to be 261. Let's write down and check. 261. Okay, correct. All right. So moving to question number two. A researcher wants to determine an interval estimate for average weight of adult gorillas in pounds. She wants to be 80% certain, okay? It's gonna be 80% certain. All right. That she is within 7.1 of the true average. That's our margin of error, 7.1. Okay. From past studies, it is known that standard deviation of the weight of adult gorilla is 16.1. So sigma is standard deviation, sigma is 16.1. Okay. So we need to find minimum. What's a minimum sample size? Okay, let's go start crunch. Since the standard deviation is given, we are going to use z-scores because standard deviation is given z-stat. Here we go, one sample. And we are going to choose width sample size. Okay, so our confidence level is 80%, 7.1 and 16.1, okay. 80%, we put here 0.8. Standard deviation was, I think, 16.1, correct? 16.1, okay, and width was how much? 7.1, and so we need to double for to tell. It's going to be 14.2. Compute, and we are getting sample size of 9. Okay, let's see. 13.75, so it's something wrong. I did put something else. 7.1, 14.2. Okay, we need to put 14.2. Okay, so it's 9. All right, let's try. Correct. The answer is correct. Okay, and we are done. 8.4. We have only two questions, so congratulations. That's a last problem, I believe. I'll double check, make sure I didn't leave any assignment. So I will have only maybe quiz 8 and test 3. I'll check it. I'll make sure I won't miss it. And if I miss something, I know my student won't let me forget. I will receive email that I haven't recorded this assignment, so we will be safe. Okie dokie then. So you work on your side and I will continue working on my end. Okie dokie.